Live right now, are you cheap if you tip less than 25%?
25%?
Yeah.
Oh boy, new article out just this morning says you are cheap if you're not tipping 25%. You got to hear the reason why.
Plus, take a look at this photo a mom of three posts on Facebook. She wants to know, why don't you look like her? Is it fat shaming? We've heard of moms delivering their baby in a hospital, but the hot new trend, how about giving birth in a swanky hotel room? Madonna banned from movie theaters. Find out what she did during a film to get her kicked out. We've seen dating sites for almost everything. How about the new site that hooks you up with a ghost? Plus, forget about the petting zoo, the new futuristic zoo that lets you pet robots instead.
Oh, Lord. The petting zoo's always scared me anyway. The goats always went after me.
Petting a robot? How soft and cuddly can that be?
Welcome to the Everyday Show live on this Tuesday. Good to see you, Mel.
Good to see you, too.
We got a crazy hour, including I'm giving away free DVDs later in the hour. But out of the gate, this one has our newsroom riled up. It just came in today. If you're on Facebook, you may have seen this picture this morning.
Yes.
Are you a lazy mom if you're not fit and ripped with washboard abs?
This is ridiculous.
That's what this mom says. Her name's Maria Kang. She posted this photo on Facebook and it says, what's your excuse? And then she showed her kids. You know, I've got three kids. I'm still ripped. I look like a supermodel.
It doesn't surprise me that those kids are each, it looks like, 1 year apart.
Yeah.
Like, they didn't waste any time in the bedroom making
those kids.
But
here's the thing. She says she's just trying to inspire women to be their best, and that she really wants to say, hey, if I can do it, anyone can. But don't you think the way she phrased it is offensive? What's your take?
I just think it's kind of silly, because I didn't even look like that before I had a dog. Like, when it was just me, 20 years old, I still didn't look that good.
I've never had kids. I don't look that good. Here's my thing. Number one, I don't need an excuse. Women don't have to look like that to
be
beautiful.
Yeah.
That is unrealistic. I think it is shaming women that if you don't look like a supermodel, you have excuses because you're lazy.
And I want to know how much time she spends every day in the gym and working on her body, because realistically, moms don't have that time in their day.
Right. And moms don't have to look like that to be successful and happy and healthy. So the woman's getting a lot of heat today. If she had phrased it and said, hey,
do you want to look like this? If you're a mom, I've got an answer for you.
Right.
Something like that.
Anyway. It's a big, big talker.
Okay, another talker today. I'm getting so tired of these stories, I'm now putting them in a file that I call, What Are Schools Banning Now?
Okay.
How about one of my favorite songs?
What is it?
Hit it, boys.
Oh, I like this one. Home sweet home to me, everybody. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Well, what's wrong with this song? I love it.
Well, apparently, good old Rocky Top. It's catchy, it's a classic, of course. Now it's banned at one school in Indiana. Why?
Why are they banning it?
Right, because they say the song's lyrics are inappropriate. In particular, there's one line that talks about finding moonshine. It says that once two strangers climbed a rocky top looking for a moonshine still. Right.
Now here, the kids sing this song during the football games. It's their rally song.
Right.
School says can't do it because the song references moonshine.
So they would rather play, 50 Cent? And Tupac talking about murdering other people and talking about the Benjamins, because that is clearly a better message.
Now, this school is in Indiana, Plymouth, Indiana.
So ridiculous.
Honestly, it's Andy Griffith talked about moonshine in 1965. It's silly. It's just stupid.
It's ridiculous. I'm writing a letter.
Better
to the chancellor of that school.
Better still, we're gonna drink moonshine on this show. Make some noise for moonshine.
All two of our audience members.
We've got two fans of moonshine. Cannot believe it.
All right. Sharon and Tina, right?
They love moonshine.
Sharon and Tina.
I mean, schools are getting out of control. We're going to play the song again today because I love it so much.
Mm-hmm.
Another hot talker today.
Yes.
You know, it's a gal that I used to really love.
Used to being the operative words in that sense.
It's Madonna.
When was she ever like a virgin? I'm just asking.
Long time ago.
Clearly.
So Madonna is not one to shy away from controversy. Here's the latest. Just came into the newsroom.
Yeah.
She was in New York.
Oh, right.
She was watching the very serious movie 12 Years a Slave. It's a powerful movie.
Right.
So give me your phone, would you? She's in the movie, and she's doing this. During the serious film, Madonna, Madonna, Madonna.
Scheduling her next yoga slash Pilates slash weightlifting session, I'm sure.
She's texting during the movie, okay? And somebody said, would you mind not doing that? It's distracting.
Good for them.
She said, you're an enslaver. Quit enslaving me, is what she said. And kept on texting. So now, Alamo Drafthouse, big movie theater chain, they have one in Littleton, banning Madonna.
Good.
They will not let her in a theater until she apologizes for what she did. Do you think she was out of line?
Yes. I think it's rude to everyone else in the theater because that little light that, you know, whatever you're doing, if it's business, fine, step out of the theater.
Okay, now let me ask you this, honestly.
It's distracting.
If it was Madonna, one row ahead of you, would you have enough courage to say to Madonna, hey, cut that out, woman?
Chris, you've met me. You clearly know I would have no problem being like, excuse me, that's annoying and distracting.
It could be the Pope sitting ahead of you and you'd say something to him.
Yes.
Hey, take your hat off, I can't see.
Excuse me, Mr. Pontiff, could you please remove your hat? No, I'm just kidding. Maybe not the Pope, but Madonna, yes.
I'm with you. You should be able to take 2 hours out of your day, turn off the phone, and be transported in a movie.
And I'm sure she has like 25 assistants and handlers.
Exactly.
Let them respond to the text.
Get with it.
All right, let's talk about tipping at restaurants. So here's a question.
Yeah.
If you tip 20%, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are you being stingy? 20%?
No.
Turns out an article in USA Today says that you should tip more than that usual 15 to 20%. The writer of the article says, look, these servers earn next to nothing. They're only earning usually about $2 an hour.
Okay, that's true.
So it's below minimum wage. Their only source of income is really your tip. So you should be tipping 25% minimum.
Listen, here's my thing. I always, always tip 20%.
Me too.
Mostly because I'm bad at math. And 20% is easy to figure out.
Move the decimal times it by two.
Move a decimal times
two.
That's
exactly what I do.
I cannot do 25%. That's going to involve paper and pencil. No.
I don't even, you know how you're supposed to not tip on alcohol? I tip on everything just because there's more math involved if I have to not tip on alcohol.
So we asked you on Facebook, really, is a quarter of your tab, 25%, too much to tip? We got a ton of comments on Facebook today.
Yeah. Candace wrote, minimum 20%, more for excellent service. I've been a server and realized making $2 an hour is not going to pay the bills. If you can't afford to tip, though, don't eat out. I think Candace has got a point.
Well, Kathy says, my tip's based on attitude and service. It's earned, not given, just like I have to earn my tip as a hairdresser.
Oh, I like that, yeah. Yep. Michelle wrote, 25%, who tips that? It's always been 20% if the service was excellent.
Again, the math is easier.
Yep.
Give me 20%. Jennifer says, they'd better start making the food cheaper if they want tips that bigger. Tips are a reflection of service. They're not a flat fee.
They are. I think that's what's important to remember. There are times where the service has been so bad that I've been forced to tip less than 20%. I hate doing it, but there are times when,
well,
I just can't help
it. We love it when you join the conversation. This show is your show. We're all friends sitting around a coffee table together. Mm-hmm. So when you're on Facebook, search for Colorado's Everyday Show.
Click, click.
Like us and jump right in. Tell us what's on your mind. We'd love to hear from you.
Yes.
Every day on the show, if you're a regular, you know this, I find some way to pressure Melody into having children.
And nothing does it quite like the sound of babies crying. There's really no better way.
You really would be a good mom.
Who doesn't want to have a baby when you hear that?
You'd be a great mom. You really would. You're loving, you're kind, you're gentle, you're sensitive.
I barely have time for my dog right now.
Well, here's when you do.
It's not fair.
When the day comes, may I suggest you go to the Four Seasons, spread out some towels, and pop out that baby right in the hotel room floor.
Really? That's your idea?
Ding!
Yeah.
This is a new trend. Article came out today. Women now are giving birth in hotel rooms. Fancy ones. The article.
Come on.
MommyDish.com today says.
Have a little consideration for the housekeeper.
Mom's
gross.
Well, they prefer this because you get total privacy. You get to be pampered. You get some reminders of everyday life because it is a room. And there's not the stress of a hospital room. You wouldn't do this?
No, it seems wrong. Excuse me, we have placenta in the carpet on room 1301.
Oh,
can you go clean it? Like, are you kidding?
Oh, jeez.
That's just wrong.
You had to go there.
That poor person has to clean up that mess.
You know those little investigations they do with the black light where they see what's in there?
It's
afterbirth. Oh, Lord.
There's a reason hospital rooms don't have carpeted floors.
Okay, you do have a point. You do.
All right, so moving on from babies, let's talk about sex. That's my favorite topic.
It is your favorite topic.
Yeah, pretty much. Yesterday, we told you how eating chocolate, you know, can improve a man's performance, which is why I went to Sam's Club right after the show and bought a giant box of chocolates. Yeah.
For Ricky.
Well, now there's something that can help the ladies out in the bedroom. I'm a huge fan of this story.
You are?
Because I really want to do this.
You want to do this?
Getting breast implants.
Oh.
That's right.
What?
A new study out of Brazil found that women who had cosmetic surgery to enhance their breast size experienced a better sex life.
Mm-hmm.
Researchers say women got in the mood after they had the procedure done. I'm hoping that was after all the drugs wore off. They say that's because it boosted their confidence.
Well, now I can see if
Dad, this is my reasoning.
Your dad is not going to pay for breast implants.
Oh, forget pay. I'm just looking for permission. He's never going to pay for it.
Now, here's my thing. In all seriousness, if you feel good about how you look, you are more confident.
I think so, yeah.
But it's sad to me that you would think you're not beautiful just the way you are. You don't need any changing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's just my opinion.
Well, I think that's because you've always seen me in a padded bra. I think, you know.
Maybe that's true.
If you saw the 14-year-old boy's chest that was under the padding.
Oh, stop it. Stop it. You're beautiful just the way you are.
Love you for saying that.
You know, while Melody might be on Google searching for, you know, plastic surgeons.
Right, saline or silicone.
Here is today, this story came in. What do you think Americans are obsessed about? What do you think they're Googling more than anything else right now?
Justin Bieber, Miley Cyrus.
It might be it's kind of like Justin. Take a look.
Now you can relieve inflamed hemorrhoidal tissue with the oxygen action of preparation H.
Yes.
It accelerates absorption.
Some would say that Bieber is a hemorrhoid. Believe it or not, hemorrhoids. It is now one of the top Google searches in America. We're obsessed with it. The number of Google searches for hemorrhoid has doubled. Now, 80,000 times a week, Americans are searching for hemorrhoid in Google.
I want to see how many times Google has to spell check, like has to correct the spelling of hemorrhoid.
Yeah, I can't spell hemorrhoid.
Yeah.
Why are we searching for this?
I don't know.
Clearly, you don't want to see photos.
I don't know. Google imaging? Yeah.
And not to give away too much on this show, but we should let you know that we are sitting on pillows.
Yeah, we both sit on pillows. Which
For obvious reasons.
Excuse me, I do want to point out that my pillow was to make me as tall as you, and then you started using the pillow, which just shrunk me right back down.
Hey, listen, if you've got a problem, pillows can help alleviate that inflamed
feeling. Okay, all right, that's about enough. We're all guilty of this next one, taking
a selfie.
That's right, one
of these. You are a duck face culprit.
It's because I don't know what else to do. It's either that or just awkward me, like.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so remember the duck face trend that Chris was just blaming me about?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's a trend everyone used to do when they took a picture. Well, the duck face is so 2012.
Yeah, what's the new trend?
Passé, my friends. Look at the new trend.
What's it called?
It is sparrow face. That's right. It's the trend taking Japan by storm. All you've got to do is just open your eyes wide.
Yeah.
And then part your mouth just slightly.
They say you're supposed to look like a little baby sparrow wanting to be fed from the nest. So you open your mouth a little bit.
Okay, let's try.
Kind of angle your face
open
up.
Open your mouth, okay.
Wide-eyed. It's called the sparrow. It's a hot new thing. What do you think?
Move. Our producer's saying move your mouth.
There.
Oh, don't move your mouth. Okay.
It's a good thing we already have boyfriends because we would be single forever if we did the sparrow face. Ah, boy.
Yes, we would.
We're glad you're sharing your hour with us. Sparrow face, duck face, we love you
no matter
what.
Whatever.
Coming up next, what's the worst job in Denver? The list is out today and you're going to hear it.
And it's the zoo of the future, apparently. Nothing cuter, softer, cuddlier than robots.
Has it come to this?
Yeah.
Okay.
It has.